all these extra sensors in the vehicle, as you talked about, the connectivity, it's driving all these new features that we see today. And I know that that's creating a fundamental shift in the architecture. You mentioned advanced electrical architectures. And Lee, I know that's something you're working on with your team, is really taking this holistic view to the vehicle and a fundamental redesign of the architecture. Why don't you tell us a little bit more about that?
Advanced safety, user experience, chassis propulsion are all examples of systems that rely heavily on electrical architecture. The explosion of software-driven features highlight the prominent role that architecture is playing today and ultimately has to play in the future. If you look at architecture, it is the natural integrator. It touches every part of the vehicle. It's the realization and manifestation how our customers actually want to build their vehicle and ultimately how the end user experiences it. Smart vehicle architecture was born because we discovered a break in the ability to deliver these extended features as we continue down the path to full safety automation.
What do you mean by break?
It's the inability to bring the features down reasonably into the vehicle. Another element that we shouldn't forget is speed. Technology in our industry is advancing rapidly, and we must have a better architectural approach in order to be able just to keep pace. So smart vehicle architecture, basically, we reimagine the architecture from the ground up to be flexible, affordable, a scalable end-to-end solution, if you will, taking everything into account from sensor to cloud. And that's what we call smart vehicle architecture.
The other thing that you've talked a lot about in the past is fail operational design.
Right.
And as a technology provider with a lot, 100 plus years of automotive experience, we know automotive grade. But the other thing we know is functionally safe design. Why don't you tell us about how smart vehicle architecture comprehends fail operation?
Right, so fail operational design, we call it a three-layer approach, and it deals with power, data, and compute. So in the event that a self-driving vehicle has a failure in any one of these layers, the vehicle has to be able to get itself out of harm's way. So we have designed in fail-safe mechanisms for redundant power. So in the event that one of the devices inside of the architecture loses power, we're able to recover from that. The same thing goes for data. We have a redundant data architecture that in the event that we lose any link, we can use the secondary link to make sure that the data is communicated properly. And then finally, compute. In the event that you do have a problem where you may lose an entire computer, so it's not power, it's not data, it's actually the entire compute, we have another instance that's running in the background to make sure that we bring the vehicle to a safe stop.
Glenn, why is smart vehicle architecture so important today?
Consistent with how we think about providing value to our customers and looking at our portfolio, one of the unique things about Aptiv is we have both the electrical architecture piece as well as the compute and the software. We understand all the content, you know, from sensors down to actuation. And what our customers are struggling with today is as more and more content comes into the vehicle. Well, historically, that's meant more and more wires. We've gone from a mile of copper to 2 miles of copper to 3 miles of copper on premium vehicles. And at some point, you just can't put more wires in the car. And so they're really looking for a way to continue to add value, continue to add content to the vehicle, but not make it add mass weight and, you know, mass weight, volume and cost and complexity for assembly. As we studied the problem, we started our smart vehicle architecture group about a year ago with Lee championing that. And we really brought together disciplines from all around Aptiv. And the intent was to look at the vehicle more holistically and to be able to say, here's how you can bring that content in, but actually reduce your total system cost and reduce and address the problems at the vehicle assembly plant.
The issue today is you add a feature, you add a box. And we've distributed then these boxes all around the vehicle, and that's reached a point where integration, testing, validation, all the key elements, the non-visible elements of putting features on the road, it doesn't function anymore. What's unique about Aptiv is, and really the joy of my job, is I had the ability not to go to walk across the hall, speak to somebody, how should I be looking at this, as opposed to try to go outside of our company to get the answer. So we followed it through. We started with the sensor, we then with the connector, then you have the wire harness, going to central compute, ultimately making its way to the cloud, and that's what makes smart architecture powerful, but also resonate with our customers. They say, you are the only company that can talk to us at eye level about this issue.